For my presentation, I asked several of my friends to find one word to describe me. And three of them called me a hipster. That was a joke, but I took it seriously, so I decided to find out what do I have that sometimes refers me to those strange people like hipsters. So I had a look at myself, and what did I see? First of all, I have a beard, as you have posted, you can see. And you might be jealous, but I wake up at noon. I also describe myself sometimes as a freelance designer. And sometimes you can see me, for example, at Gorky Park or somewhere else, driving a scooter, you know, when you push with your leg. That's kind of a big hipster, I think. But that's not everything about me. Hipster by day, at night, I become a very dull person. I'm finishing my dissertation paper on political sciences. And that's not a very interesting thing. For me it's interesting, but not for the common audience. But there is something else that I'm really happy about. I'm trying to develop my presentation skills like I do here today. And as a presenter, I know that talking and talking and talking, if you don't have a really good story, as the previous presenter had, is not a very good idea. So I prepared several slides about myself as well. I draw them myself. So, that is my daily routine. So you can see that actually calling me in the morning is a very, very bad idea. And yes, that's kind of the scooter I was referring to. But I'm afraid you cannot actually get why am I waking up with the brush and some colors in my hand. So I brought you some examples of what I do as a graphic designer. I prefer brochures, like these ones. You can have a look if you want to. So I make sometimes not interesting text, more interesting with and more appealing with photos, graphs, numbers, and so on. That's one thing. Another thing is my dissertation. I brought you a sample. Mine is twice as big as this one. It's almost 200 pages. And I'm digging into different instruments and kind of mechanisms of improving international image of Russia abroad. So I'm hoping to finish it in to get my PhD in half a year. And right now it's a very responsible period for me. So that's almost everything I do, except presentations. So you may ask me, why was I talking about myself that much? I was actually not. I was showing you three ways of presenting information I usually do. For example, when I hold my seminars or classes at the university. And they are, of course, through hearing, or listening, through seeing, or through having something to touch, to interact with in your real world. And some researchers say that these three elements split our audience into three groups, and you have to give every part of this audience one example of this or that. But I believe that's not that right. We do go from all these three types. You might prefer seeing or hearing, but it depends on the person. But you, for sure, you can learn both and from hearing and from seeing something. And so, I have an idea that all of these three types should be used just whenever they they suit you the best, your purpose the best. Whether you have to focus on your ideas, to distill your your thoughts and create some logic, whether you have to show others what you see and get them bigger picture or compare something, or when they don't just have to hear something, but they have to learn something, there is always a good idea to let them do what they want. For example, try something new. And that's what I'm trying to do right now, right here. I'm letting you not just see and hear, but try something. I think our four presenters that are coming will have their try. So thank you very much.
Thank you.